it is my first time to be a host. I'm so very nervous now. Please understand it. Today's talk is energy use and climate change, Korea and the world. The speaker is, before we get started, please turn off your phone or be silent. If during the talk or during the Q&A session you have any questions, so please write them down in the paper that was given to you and hand it to one of the volunteers. Today's speaker is Douglas Baumor, and the topic is energy use and climate change, Korea and the world. Please give him a big applause.
Okay, hello everybody.
Hello.
So my name is Douglas, and this is the topic. Maybe not super happy topic, but we all have to think about this topic a lot, okay? I worked for 6 years with the United States government in Ministry of Environment, a long time ago. And now I'm teaching writing in Damyang, Gyeonggyeongsuwon, teaching writing and critical thinking. Okay, so this is the world from space. We have to remember that this Earth is borrowed from our children, okay? So we don't own the Earth, we're giving the Earth to our children. We have to give them the Earth in good condition, right? These are some grassroots environmental organizations. Grassroots means the people, okay? Not government, not companies. So, I listed these on the paper that you have. So after the talk, you can search online. This second group, this one, they have an office in Gwangju. And if you speak with some people at the GIC, or you can look online, you can try to get involved local in Gwangju and talk to them about what they're doing for the environment. This is a group, another group, this one, from Seoul. So you can see they have many members. Okay. This one, 350.org, this is the most important world organization for air pollution. Okay. So if you go to this website, you can find more information. And this man, Bill McKibben, right now is the most famous, probably most important speaker for air quality. Air quality is a big problem in Korea, if you've noticed. Lately in Gwangju, okay, older people really can't go outside because this can be very dangerous for their health. We'll talk about that later. My degree is in philosophy. So, you know Aristotle?
Yes.
Plato? Okay, but for me, philosophy just means asking questions, okay? You just ask questions. Why should you ask me? This is a joke. Okay. Second part. Okay, status quo. Do you know status quo? Okay, Latin. Latin, this means the current situation, the way things are. Okay. Status quo for Donald Trump, perfect. Okay. He's a millionaire. His parents gave him millions of dollars. He did not work for his money. He just got money from his parents. This lady, this Korean woman, I mean, she's working very hard. Government is giving her only $300,000 every month. Okay. Not good status quo for her. Okay, you can't really see. These are some African American people. This is not Africa. This is America. America has 40 million people, living in poverty. 20 million people, no food. Okay? But he's doing really well. Okay? This is a huge problem. People need to ask questions, okay? You have to question the status quo. Can you put me? Okay, these are some company names. These are the top companies in the world. Okay, number one is Walmart. This is a big department store, like Lotte or something like that. Okay, look at this one, China Petroleum. Royal Dutch Shell, this is oil company. Can you go down? Okay. Car company, oil company. Okay? So the biggest companies in the world are all automakers and oil companies. So is status quo good for them? Status quo is very good for them. Okay, we can go back to the PowerPoint. All right, here's some key ideas from this talk today. All of these ideas are related to each other. You cannot separate these ideas, okay? They're all connected. So pollution, climate change is the big thing. Climate change has many aspects, many elements. Greenhouse effect is only one. There's also drought, okay? No rain. Food scarcity, okay? 20 years in Africa, there will not be enough food. Many, many people will die. All from energy usage and pollution. Energy consumption, economics, transportation, your car, okay, the truck for E-Mart, and ships, right? Hanjin, you know Hanjin? Is Hanjin alive or dead? Okay, but there's many companies like Hanjin, okay? So for transportation, there's gasoline going into the car, and there's also emissions, okay? Emissions coming out. Electricity, this is the biggest problem in Korea. And vegetarianism, seems like it doesn't fit, but actually producing meat produces a lot of pollution. Okay, I eat meat, but every week, maybe 300 grams every week, maximum. Okay. The ecosystem. Ecosystem is a system. Everything is connected. But the world today, we have humans on top. These are ours to use, okay? Many people, in the Bible, it says God gave the nature to man to use as he wants. Okay, I disagree with this. This is not true. This is the ecosystem. Humans are inside the ecosystem. Okay, where is this?
China.
This is Seoul. So the three worst cities in the world, Seoul is number three. Okay? So when you think of this, you think of maybe India or China. This is Korea, okay? This should be embarrassing. Also, the people are breathing this air, okay? The young people, maybe it doesn't matter. The older people, this is a problem, okay? So air pollution is one kind of pollution. How about this? Do you know where this is? Where is it?
It's in the ocean.
Okay, it's in the ocean. This is Incheon. Wow. This is 7 kilometers. So this is about, I don't know, 200 kilometers, okay? This picture is from space. You can see the oil. Okay, this was about 20 years ago in Korea. Okay, so this is called water pollution. Third pollution, soil pollution. Okay, this is in China, but I guarantee in Korea there are places like this also. And here the soil is being polluted. These chemicals, they're going down into water. This water goes into the ocean. Okay, every time you use your Samsung phone, you think about this, because this comes from making computers, making phones. So this is called soil pollution. These are the three main pollutions, okay? So just with your friend, with your neighbor, why don't you just talk for 1 minute? What are the sources of air pollution in Korea? How about other countries? Do you know what fossil fuel means?
Yes.
Okay. And in your daily life, I just want you to jot down for maybe 2 minutes, how do you use energy in your life? What activities do you do that use energy? Okay. So just with your neighbor, talk for maybe 3 minutes and you can answer these questions. So when you get up in the morning, what is the how do you use energy in your house? Yeah. The two main sources. What's the one main source? Okay, transportation, cars and trucks, right? Second one? Okay, factories are there, but the main one is electricity. Okay, coal-powered electric plant. Okay, we'll talk about that later. Korea has 53 electricity plants, all of them burning coal. Okay, burning coal, thousands and thousands of kilograms every day. Okay, the smoke is coming out. In other countries, like in some countries that don't have electricity everywhere, like in India, the people in the street, they're burning wood, right? They're burning wood to boil water, and the smoke is coming off. Okay? Fossil fuel, coal, crude oil, natural gas. Okay? These are the main ones. Fossil fuel, because they came from living things. Dinosaurs, but mostly plants. Mostly plants. Okay, in your daily life, girls, when you get up, you turn on the light switch, already energy, right? When you turn on water for the shower, how does the water come up? How does it come to the top of the building? There's a pump, using electricity. When you turn on hot water, you just turn it off, but you're burning oil, right? Every time. Everything. These clothes, right? They came to D-Mart in a truck. Everything. Fruits, everything. Okay. So there's two types of waste, okay? There's something called solid waste. Solid waste is just cardboard, maybe plastic, not poisonous. This is what you can recycle. Shampoo bottle, right? Okay, all you girls. You know that the way to save the environment is recycling shampoo bottles. Okay, this really won't help, right? You need to not drive cars. We'll talk about that. Okay, and then these are the three kinds of pollution: air, water, and soil. So when someone says pollution, actually this is too general. You should ask them, do you mean air pollution, or water pollution, or soil pollution? Okay, greenhouse gases. You guys know greenhouse, right? Where you grow the plants. So methane and carbon dioxide, these are the main two. All of the animals, the cows, the pigs, when they're breathing out, they're also breathing out carbon dioxide. When they fart, methane, okay? Also, cars are producing carbon dioxide, cars. And power plants also, carbon dioxide. Okay, now actually, if you look at this truck, these, okay, but this is not, it's actually not poisonous. This is what's called particulate, okay? Particulate means very small piece of dirt. How do you say it? Okay. So in Gwangju, actually most of the air pollution is particulate. Okay, it is not poisonous, but particulates, if you breathe them in, they can cause cancer. Okay. So you have to keep in your mind, hazardous or not hazardous, but particulate is not hazardous, not toxic, but can still cause cancer. Okay. Over time. All right, this is a coal plant in Korea. This tower, this is not smoke. Do you know what this is? It's water. It's steam, okay? Steam. But steam is also part of greenhouse effect. This is smoke. This is toxic, okay? Smoke and steam are not the same. Not the same thing, but they're both bad. Also, these power plants are usually on a river. They change the temperature of the water. This kills the fish. Okay, so here, OECD, Korea is in OECD. 9 million people could die by this year from air pollution. South Korea, the worst among the members of the group of these rich countries. Okay, this is a quote from Kim Shin-do. He's professor at Seoul. He said the government is sitting idly, means not doing anything, while passing the buck to China. So Korean government is blaming China, but China is partly responsible, but Korea is also very much responsible. And a friend just told me that the people in Korea are suing the government now.
Activists are, as of 2 days ago, they're suing
okay.
China and the Korean government.
Okay. But this is a problem with international connection, because you are buying, when you go into Home Plus and you buy squid, the squid comes from China. I mean, some is from Jeju, but some is from China. When you buy shrimp, the little shrimp, it's from China. This is coming on a boat from China. The factory is in China. Okay. Can we just look at this? Okay, go down a little bit more. Okay, this is Seoul. I keep going down. Down. Okay. This is Beijing, this is Seoul, Los Angeles and New York. Most people think that Los Angeles and New York are polluted. 30 years ago, they were very bad, but it's gotten much better. Green means good days, okay? In Seoul, only 44 days in 1 year. 267 are moderate, so-so. 45 are unhealthy. And then the red ones are really unhealthy. But you can see Seoul, Shanghai, Beijing. I mean, China is worse, but not so much, right? Compared to New York, 270 green days, right? Seoul has only 44 days, just 1 month, 6 weeks, okay? Okay, we can go back to the... There will be a happy part later. All right. This is Seoul. Seoul traffic. Korea has 23 million cars. But I think this is low. Okay, this is 2013. I think today Korea has about 35 million cars. This is one Hanjin ship. One Hanjin ship sailing around the world in 1 year has the same pollution as 50 million cars in 1 year, okay? So in the world, actually cars are not, I mean, they are a problem. These ships, much more of a problem. Also, I'm only talking about this, but what about the gas going into the ship, okay? Thousands of kilograms in 1 hour. You guys ever have Hershey Kisses?
Yeah.
You can get them at Home Plus. This is from my home state, Pennsylvania. So from my house, 60 minutes. But this is coming on a boat, right? And do you really need this? Do you really need to buy chocolate from Pennsylvania? I mean, I don't think you do. Can you click on this one? Okay, I just go down a little bit. Okay, oops, I gotta stop there. And then press play.
At any given moment, tens of thousands of giant cargo ships move on around the world's ocean. These ships, some of which are more than a quarter of a mile long, are the heavy lifters of the global economy, shipping everything from metal ores and compressed gas to fresh fruit and plastic toys. This interactive map shows the movements of the world's commercial shipping fleet in 2012, based on
hundreds of... Okay, the other one, you can look at that later at home. But this is all of the ships in the world. This is their path. Okay? 90,000. So you can see from the path, you can see the continents. This is not a picture of the world. This is just the ships are going around, so you can see each continent here. Okay, the other one, which isn't working, is showing each ship going around the world. Okay, this is a typical port, right? Like Busan or Incheon. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 container ships. And they're changing maybe every 12 hours. So just constant ships. All of these here, these are the containers, the big containers that you see. Okay, how much oil does Korea produce? Zero. But how much does Korea use? Okay. Every day about 2.2 million barrels. Every day, 2 million barrels. Okay, and you buy your gasoline here, but none of this is from Korea. It's all being imported. Think how much money Korean economy is spending on this. If they can use solar energy, then they save all of the money. No pollution. Okay, Korea is the second largest importer of coal and liquefied natural gas in the world. Okay, fifth largest importer of crude oil. So all of this money, all of these lights, all of the open doors in Home Plus with the air conditioning just going out. Okay, this is all money. It's all money at the moment. This is China. So all of these cars, they're all burning gasoline, right? They all have pollution going into the air. So this is when you're driving your car, this is what's coming out the back. This is greenhouse gas. This is general term. This is particulate. The problem in Gwangju. And this is another one. So this is our solution, okay? Does Korea have electric cars?
Yes.
Okay. Kia, Hyundai, I think they both have electric cars. So maybe 20 years in the future we can see this. How much pollution comes from the back of this car? How much pollution? Zero, right? Zero. This is a barrel of oil. 47% of this crude oil, okay, crude oil is the original product from the ground. So 47% is gasoline, about 80 liters. 23% diesel fuel, this is for ships, and heating oil for your home. Okay, jet fuel, 10%, this is jet fuel. So from every barrel of oil, these are the products, okay? So Korea is using 2 million barrels every day. US, United States, is using 20 million barrels every day. Just oil, coal is extra. Okay. Okay, with your neighbor, you think about this oil, okay? How much energy is in this? If I light this on fire, I take my lighter and I light it and it burns, how much energy is in there? So one barrel of oil, if you imagine a man outside, he's working on the highway and he's like hitting something like this for 8 hours, okay? This is 8 hours of labor. 8 hours of labor. So how much is in one barrel? How much energy is in there? Maybe 5 hours, 10 hours, 100 hours? Okay, one barrel of oil is the same. It's the same as a human being working 8 hours a day, 5 days a week, 50 weeks a year, times 10 years. So 20,000 hours. So the man who's outside or the woman who's outside and they're hitting like this, they're using energy, 10 years is the same as one barrel of oil. Okay? So this means that everything that's built around us with machines, if we were using people, it would be impossible. There's not enough people. This is what's called unsustainable. It's not sustainable. All right, in Korea, this is crude oil. This is what crude oil looks like when it comes out of the ground. After it goes to the factory, you have gasoline and jet fuel and stuff like that. So every day, every man, woman, and child burns 7 liters of crude oil. Everyone in here, you're using 7 liters of oil every day. 50 million people, right? So all of the pollution from that, it's all going in the air. Okay, this is not possible. There's something called climate change denier. Have you heard this in English? Okay, Donald Trump is a climate change denier. He believes that the climate is not changing from human activity. He believes either it's happening naturally or it's just not happening at all. So Donald Trump and 50% of Americans, my people, they believe there's no such thing as climate change. I'm called an alarmist. So I'm an alarmist because I think there's a problem. Okay, deniers, they refuse to acknowledge the world economy is unsustainable. They will not acknowledge that humans can affect something so big as the environment. They say it's impossible that we can actually affect the whole environment. Okay, another thing is that they cannot be told what to do. They say, the government tells me to do something. No, I'm not doing it because I'm free. I'm a free person. And they have to question their own beliefs and they have to change the way they live. Now, when you're on the highway, how many people are in every car? When you're in a traffic jam, in Gwangju, and you look around, how many people are in the other cars?
Mostly one.
Almost always one person. This is not efficient. You know, there needs to be a law that you cannot have empty seats in your car. Okay, on the airplane, last time I flew to New York, the airplane was more than half empty. But we're still burning all of the jet fuel to get there. Okay. I think there should be a law where the planes are like a taxi. They're at the airport, and people just come, they get on. When the plane is full, it goes to China or it goes to New York. You should not have empty seats on an airplane. Okay, again, the lights. When you turn on the lights, I mean, what happens? This is Hong Kong, okay? Famous for the lights downtown. They have a laser show. I mean, I've seen it. It's pretty cool. But actually, I really shouldn't enjoy it because there's an environmental cost. This is a coal field in America. This is a coal field in India. Okay, look at how much coal is in this. This woman is carrying this on her head. In Korea, in the last 10 years, they have increased 95%, double the amount of coal used in Korea. carbon dioxide emissions, this is greenhouse gas, right? First, number one. 40% of the energy here is from coal. 30% is from nuclear energy. Also a problem. This is called Dongjin coal plant. It's in Chungcheong province. This is the biggest coal plant in the world. The biggest in the world. Again, this is not steam. This is smoke. Smoke is not steam. Smoke is much worse. So 26 of 53 coal-fired plants are in this province, in Korea. So in the next 30 years, Korea is building 20 new coal plants. I mean, this is where you have to call. You have to call your government. You have to say, I don't want this. I want something different. I mean, Korea just got rid of Park Geun-hye from a combined effort. I want to see people in Seoul, millions, saying we don't want coal. Same reason, right? Okay, I don't know if you know this, but in an electric power plant, it's a very brute force method. Brute force, it means not efficient. So here's the coal, okay? All this coal is going in, and they burn it with flame. All that an electric plant does is boil water. That's all it does. The water is in here, and it's getting boiled. So steam comes off the water, right? Steam comes off boiling water, and it turns this engine, and this creates electricity. All of the coal being burned, the only point is to boil water. It seems ridiculous. Okay, from here, it goes through the transmission lines, and it goes to your house, okay? Here's the river, which is getting this warm water, which can kill the fish, and also changes the level, so the birds and the ducks, they can't live there. All right, these are power lines here. Now when electricity comes through here, some of it disappears. It just disappears, about 8%. So if you look at this, here's the power plant. The coal is going in 100% energy, but 44 to 60% of the energy, it's just lost. It's gone, burning the coal. Then the energy comes through the wires, 8% gone. So when it gets to your house, from the original 100% of energy, only 30% to 50% is actually in the house. So half of it is just gone. But all the smoke and everything, right, is there. But this is why solar energy is 100% efficient. Okay, there's no waste for solar energy. Wind energy, very little waste. Okay, looking at vegetarianism just really quickly. So this is kilowatt hours. You guys know kilowatt hour? This is how you measure electricity. So if this light is burning, how does it work? I can't remember. Kilowatt hour. 1 kilowatt. Okay, this light for 1 hour, that's 1 kilowatt hour. Look at your parents' bill from Kepco. Every month, using maybe 200 kilowatt hours, 100 kilowatt hours, and you pay for this, right? So to produce 1 pound of beef, okay, 400 grams, takes about 30 kilowatt hours. So one kilowatt hour, like electric heater that you have in your bedroom, the electric heater, that's about 1 kilowatt. So if you turn that on for 30 hours, all of that energy, you just get 400 grams of beef. Okay? So corn takes very little. So we should be eating more corn, less beef. All right, milk, apples, chicken, actually not so bad, but pork and beef a lot. So if the whole world would just stop driving and stop eating meat, the energy problem would, I mean, it wouldn't disappear, but it would be much, much better. Okay, so Korea's energy future, you have to think about economics. Okay, companies need some profit, right? Also, people need jobs. Okay, this is actually really the biggest one. GDP, gross domestic product. Everyone knows GDP? All right, the whole economic theory for the last 100 years says if GDP goes up, that your country is better. It's better off, but this isn't true. GDP is not a good measure of the health of a country. Okay, I don't have time to tell you about that, no. Externalities, these are called external costs. When you pay for gasoline, there's the cost of all the old people getting sick, and the Korean healthcare system has to pay for all of this. Okay, this is called an external cost. No one is paying for it when they buy the gasoline. The company isn't paying for it. You're paying for it through your tax for healthcare. So this is not fair. Companies should pay this, not people. Okay, do you guys know what some renewable energy sources are? Renewable?
Sun.
Okay, solar is maybe the main one. Water. Wind. Okay. Do you know tide? Tide? In the ocean? Yeah. Okay, geothermal. There's some heat underground. Okay, actually, Korea does have a tidal power plant. On the, I can't remember, but on the coast, Korea does have a tidal plant, so they are at least thinking about it a little bit. But really the problem, the other problem in Korea is nuclear, okay? Nuclear is very clean. When it burns, it's very clean. But when you're done burning, okay, the waste that's left, this is extremely poisonous for maybe 500,000 years, okay? So this is in America. This is one barrel of nuclear waste. Okay, this is all here. They just dug this out under the ground. They dug it out. They're just putting the stuff in there, and they just close it. So future generations, children, we just say, oh, here you go. So imagine there's an earthquake here. All of these, if these all get broken open, they're all going into the ground, and no one can live there. Fukushima, compared to this, Fukushima is nothing. It's nothing. So Korea has about 30 nuclear power plants. So ask your teacher, ask your science teacher, where is this in Korea? Because I guarantee in Korea there's probably 10 places like this. And if your science teacher doesn't know, you tell them to find out. Okay, so we have budgets, right? We make a budget for home, for money. Like, I spend too much at Home Plus. Every week, 100,000, too much. But anyway, I have to lower my budget for Home Plus. But we need an energy budget, okay? Everyone should be given maybe 100 kilowatt hours per person, and you can use it how you want. So do you use a hairdryer? You stop. Don't use the hairdryer because you need your energy for something else, right? How about you can take a cold shower. Cold shower, but use a hairdryer. All right, so I think we need energy budgets for people. And if you use too much energy, you're done. No more energy for you this month. So you have to wash all of your plates by hand, and you have to wash your clothes out in the stream, out in the river. Your grandparents did it, you know? I mean, they lived. So this is typical in a house. This is how you're using your energy. Refrigerator, dryer, electronics, lighting, water heater, heating and cooling, 49%. Maybe people shouldn't live in cold climates. Everyone should live near the equator. All right, so again, you have to remember that the environment is not just for us to use, okay? We're in the ecosystem. And these are the sources. So if you try these searches online, if you search these, if you use Google or Yahoo, you have to use English. If you search in Korean on Google, it doesn't work as well. Naver in Korean is excellent. But for many things, there's more information in English. So you have to use Google. Okay, if you search in Naver using English, the search results are very bad. Okay? So try some of these searches. These are some Korean places for additional information. And this guy, Kim Shindo, he's from Seoul National University. You can send him an email. Seriously. I bet he'll answer you. You say, I'm a middle school, high school student, and I'm interested, blah, blah, blah. Maybe. I know it's not Korean culture, but Korean culture is changing, okay? So, and these are the all the oil and all of the energy information. This is a US government website, free. Has all of the information. All right, so in the future, solving the problem, I mean, it involves vegetarian, it involves electric cars, it involves not turning your heat up to 28 degrees in the wintertime. You keep it, my apartment this winter, 16 degrees. 16, yeah. I just wear a sweater inside and socks, okay? You need to share the car. All of these things, the future is going to be very different. If we don't change the picture of Seoul, that's going to be every day, right? Okay, thank you very much.
So thank you for the outstanding talk. So now is the Q&A session. So if you have questions or suggestions, comments, then write them down on the paper and give it to the volunteers later.
Is that Mr.? Is that Mr.?
Thank
you.
It is very different to breathing. So when we go outside, then what do you think is the best solution in the future to reduce the...
In the future, you have to have
electric cars.
Yeah, because there's no emission and no coal plants.
But I think it will just at least more than 10 years to be replaced by electric cars.
I think cars can be replaced quickly, maybe 10 years. Coal plants longer, maybe 10 years. We can change the cars in 5 or 10 years. But everyone has to agree.
The car company doesn't really win.
Of course. But they can still make money selling electric cars. Right? They just don't want to change because the profits are too big.
Okay. I have a Q&A course today, and today we only got some questions. The first question we got here is, first, hydroelectronics.
So hydroelectricity, this is just when you build the dam. So you have a dam, you have the river like this, river, and you put the dam in, so it stops the water. Usually the wall is about maybe 30 meters or more. Some are 100 meters. And when the water falls down, the engine has to turn, right, like this. So the water falls over it and it turns it. And this is what's creating electricity. Hydroelectric. So Korea has some, but there's a problem, right? Because when you put the river's coming, you put the wall, now the water's going up and it's covering everything. If there's a town there or nature. But also you're changing the river flow. It's changing nature. So hydroelectric is clean, zero pollution, no pollution from hydroelectric.
Thank you for your question. And the next question is, how about air pollution from neighboring countries? How does it affect to Korea?
I mean, this is the problem. Do you guys know Global Village? Global village is a term. It means the whole world is connected now. But you are, Korea is consuming products from China. So Korea is partly responsible for the air pollution from the factory in China. So Korea can't complain when the factory from here that makes the product that Korea is buying, when the pollution is coming to Korea, I mean, Korea is partly responsible for that.
Let me address my question though. Well, that the problem is might be very small part of the whole pollution.
Yeah.
However, you know, it's I think it's very much relative, unfair. Mm. You know, the various pollutions in Korea, they support us in comfortable life.
Yeah.
For you know the daily products. Mm. However, from the China, such as you know the yellow dust or yellow sand, that's because that's, we are neighboring to China.
That's true.
We don't have any responsibility or duty.
No, that's true.
So my question is, in that case, how is the regulation in international society? Mm.
I mean, so the yellow dust coming from China, right? This is from the Gobi Desert. You know Gobi Desert, right?
Yeah.
Gobi Desert is getting bigger every year because of drought. There's no rain. This is a part of climate change. Everyone in the world is responsible for climate change. So again, Korea is partly responsible for yellow dust, but not completely responsible. But, I mean, we have to realize that everything is connected. I mean, I'm buying beef from America in HomePlus. I mean, why? I like Korean beef, it's better. And, I mean, the boats coming, creating pollution, this is also affecting the Gobi Desert. So, I don't know. I mean, I don't know what the answer is. But the whole world is coming together with one world. I mean, this is why I have a job as an English teacher.
No regulation or any compensation. If we get a lot of air pollution from China, we cannot, you know, write a decree to China, something like that.
I don't know. I mean, unless you send your military, they're not going to pay you. So maybe Korea will, people will have to move south. I don't know. It's a problem.
No wonder there is always some debate about societal stuff. Anyway, I got another good question. Should we slow down the advancement of our technology in order to lessen the pollution?
Okay, so look, I think one problem is that the only consideration before a company makes a new product is profit. There's no consideration for the environment. So in my opinion, governments should say the environment can't change. So you make your product, you do whatever you want, but you have to leave the environment the way you found it. All right? There's a saying called NIMBY, not in my backyard. You've heard this?
Yeah.
Okay, so NIMBY, this is around for a long time, but now the backyard is the whole world. It's not just in Dungeon, next to Dungeon, it's the whole world. So, when you talk about technology, you guys, the amount of pollution from a microchip, the amount of toxic waste from making one microchip in your Samsung phone or in your computer, it's huge. It's a huge amount of waste. How often do you get a new phone? Every 2 years? I mean, come on. my dad had one car for 25 years. You can't have new products all the time. It's not sustainable.
It's not working.
Yeah, well, I mean, the phone stops working, but, you know, the company could service the phone. They don't need a whole new phone. They could just service the chip or something.
Okay, another interesting question is that the slide ego, our viewers noticed that woman is positioned, located under the man, so... Everybody's really wondered why is that. So.
Well, I only noticed one human being. I didn't actually see a man and a woman.
That's a lot.
I didn't notice.
It just got unintentional. It just happened.
Maybe. Plus, I said human. I didn't say man or woman.
last question today. What is the prospect of COP21, COP21 agreement after Trump?
Oh, one more time, what's the...
What is the prospect of COP21 agreement after Trump, President Trump?
Conference of Paris.
Okay. So I can't read anymore about Trump. It makes me so upset. So I just can't read. I voted for Bernie Sanders. Early, I voted for Bernie Sanders, and then he lost, and then I voted for Hillary Clinton, and she lost. But look, Trump, it's the first time in American history that a businessman is president. So you take the president of, you know, Samsung, and you make him prime minister of Korea. I mean... But you see what's going to happen, you know? So this is the problem I was talking with her earlier. You know, corporations and businesses, they represent maybe 1% of the population, but they are telling everyone else how to live and what to accept. This is unacceptable. Look, I'm a socialist. I believe there should be no money. Everyone should just work 5 hours a day, and you get, you know, 20 pyeong, and you get 10 kilograms of rice, and you're finished. And then you just have the rest of the time. You can drink some soju and talk to your friends, you know. So I heard that the 20th century is, 19th century was the war against sort of industry and pollution. The 20th century was the century of wars, more wars in the 20th century. This century will be the fight against capitalism and corporate profit. And you look at the Chaebols. I mean, the Chaebols, they pay a lot of tax, they do. But Chaebol is running Korea, really. That's not the people. I personally think, maybe you know better, but...
What's your opinion about making a better environment?
I mean, like I said, people are gonna have to sacrifice big time. I lived in India for 6 months. I was vegetarian from the first day to the last day. No problem. Then I went back to America. The first day I ate steak. But, you know, I didn't miss it. I never owned a car. I've never owned a car. I only use public transportation or a taxi sometimes, but, you know, our cities have to be completely redesigned. You can't drive, you can't drive to 100 miles to go to work. You have to be going on a train, on a solar-powered train. Also, industry and government, they always talk about cost, the cost of environment, the cost of changing something. But if you are the company that's making the products, it's not cost, it's profit. So just the way they talk about the language is biased for business. So Donald Trump, you listen to him, how much the environment costs. But again, if my company is making like a smokestack that's doing clean smoke, my company is making money. It doesn't cost me anything, it's income. So if Samsung has to change the way they make computers, they're going to be using some other companies, those companies will make money. So next time you hear the government or businessman say environment costs money, that's just from his perspective. From the perspective of the other side, it's feeding an industry and making it bigger.
Okay, we had a lot of questions, and
Mm-hmm.
I believe our speaker had a lot of things to say, but we are out of time. So our speaker will stay here after even after the talk. You can talk with him personally. And that's it for today's Q&A session. Thank you very much, gentlemen, for answering. And now please welcome Dr. Shin, who will give a certificate of appreciation to our speaker today.
I really enjoyed your talk, which I totally agree.
Okay.
Personally, I love your personal lifestyle, because the environment movement begins from a person. Since you do not own a car,
So, not used heating much, yeah. Very nice.
That one is difficult, actually.
We put on clothes, more
clothes. Yeah,
yeah. More socks.
Yeah.
So when my wife is not at home in winter time, I do not turn on the heat. She comes back to find the very cold apartment. She does not like it. Yeah. Without her, I can put on more. And then thick blanket, which is enough.
Yeah, yeah.
So she considers me some crazy. Personally, I use the bike for nearly 4 years now.
Yeah.
And then at GIC, we do not use paper cups.
Okay, yeah.
And then we practice recycling plan rigorously. So you can see the recycling scheme of ours. So my people put the trash can at the most important part of the room. So upstairs, also inside the room, not outside. When we put them outside, the place was messy. But when put them inside, the clean, as you see. So it is our personal campaign as well as organization campaign.
Yeah.
So I brought one as well. So I do not use paper cup.
Is that whiskey?
No. So probably I may use a paper cup, probably one or two paper cups a year. Oh. So I can't be so.
Yeah, yeah.
So it is personal campaign, and then we also put the paper cup separately to put them in the paper recycling.
Mm.
So we have to collaborate more.
Yes. Okay.
So we have to be like an environmental advisor to GIC.
Yeah, okay.
This is the agreement.
Yes.
Letter of appreciation to Mr. Douglas Manbo. Thank you for your kind support to us as a guest speaker of GIC with the topic on energy use and climate change, Korea and the world. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you very much.